Ladies and gentlemen, that being all, unless staff has something that they would like to speak to?
We did speak about some potential training on the 28th of June from the Regional Commission. I've not had a confirmation on that training, so I just wanted to tell y'all, I know if we were saving the date, I will keep y'all in touch, but I don't believe they decided to hold it this month. I think they're gonna hold it for a future date, just wanna make sure you're aware.
Where will it be held, here with the meeting?
Last time they had it at the City Hall Annex in the multipurpose room.
Right.
It was a regional collection of planning commissioners, but they haven't announced yet. But last time, that's where they had it, City Hall.
You sent out a new name?
Multipurpose.
It was a little bit large for their conference room, multipurpose room, it's a whole pretty good size ground.
And you will email us, of course?
I will, I just have not heard, just wanna make sure, you know, that wasn't because I wasn't gonna tell you, because they haven't sent anything yet.
Anything else? All right, I'm looking for a motion to adjourn.
One more thing, Mr. Chairman, this is an FYI note. City staff is looking at amendments to our definitions and regulations and standards as applies to bed and breakfast inns, kind of analyzing the Airbnb concept that currently is classified the same as a bed and breakfast, although it's usually a smaller scale. This is something that's kind of new in communities. A lot of communities have not yet fully addressed it. It's sort of like the Uber version of a bed and breakfast. We have several in Valdosta that are operating already without licenses and technically in violation of the zoning code. And we've been discussing this with a few of them. And we're looking at what other communities are doing, how they're being addressed. And then even on a broader topic, even rental housing. Some of you may be familiar with vacation rentals by owner and similar organizations. So how all that interplays in terms of how to classify it as use and how to address it in our development standards. I've got some information I need to email to you, but on your next work session, let's plan on having a little bit of an informal discussion about it. We're not ready to propose amendments yet, but at least let's have some discussion. And then maybe the following month cycle, we'll come up with some proposed amendments that will run through public hearing process. So really just an FYI, look at your email, maybe something to read over the 4th of July holidays.
Matt, I have a question. How is that brought to one's attention that these facilities are operating?
We actually received a citizen complaint from a neighbor who lived next door to one that's operating and had been operating for a couple of years. And apparently some dispute arose and the neighbor started pointing and investigating and realized they were technically running a business out of their house. Not an everyday kind of thing, but just every once in a while. I think the unfortunate thing is a few folks looking for the Airbnb arrived after midnight and knocked on the wrong door. I think that sort of shined a light on what was going on there. So that raised a general question, and we started looking at it ourselves. Not knowing that we even had any in Valdosta, but we went out online and I found 5 of them. The way Airbnb works, which is actually quite interesting, they don't give specific addresses to the website. You have to make a reservation first, and then it'll tell you where to go, but otherwise it gives you a map. And we figured out a few of them. So it's just a matter of how to address them.
Anything else?
But something to think about and ponder, and I'll give you some more food for thought.
There's some issues out there, too, that have come about where the larger houses, they're renting out rooms in some of the houses, especially in the country. And, I mean, when you got 10 or 15 different vehicles sitting around the house, something's going on. And that's a violation.
There's several uses that sort of touch and overlap each other. Of course, we're in a hotels, motels, bed and breakfast of the textbook variety. Hostels is another one that's sort of similar, smaller scale. But Airbnbs, you know, come in little different flavors. And then even rental housing, whether it's long-term rental or vacation rental, is it a few rooms or is the entire dwelling? Does the owner stay on the premises, or they just rent out their whole facility? You know, and for what purposes? You know, a lot of variables that come into it, a lot of little things that sort of relate to each other.
Okay. Need a moment, ma'am?
May I please reiterate the numbers that I have for your votes, please?
You're not unanimous, was it?
Well, on the meeting minutes, I have Mr. Wiles and Ms. Gladwin. On my Lake Park case, I have Ms. Roundtree and Mr. Sandlin. Was that correct?
Did you second that?
No, but I will be.
Yeah.
Okay, Mr.
Wiles.
Thank you, sir. And on the Valdosta case.
Might look better if I say.
On the Valdosta case, I have Mr. Mullis and Ms. Gladwin. 770, is that?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, thank you.
Anything else? More strategy? All right, now I need a motion to adjourn, ladies and gentlemen.
Make a motion, we adjourn.
Second.
We adjourn.
That was.